Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed about some of the important compounds of group 16, that is oxygen and ozone. So in ozone, we have already studied some properties of ozone. It is a dark blue, pale blue gas, dark blue liquid and violet black solid, and it has a characteristic smell. In the lower concentration it is harmless, but when concentration exceeds 100 ppm it may cause a headache and nausea. And it is thermodynamically unstable with respect to oxygen because its conversion into oxygen is along with the exothermic process, and there is increase in entropy during that conversion from ozone to oxygen. Therefore, that makes delta G more negative. Hence, its conversion of ozone to oxygen is spontaneous reaction. And on decomposition, ozone releases nascent oxygen and oxygen. Because of the release of nascent oxygen, it acts as a powerful oxidizing agent. Okay, during the decomposition, it liberates nascent oxygen, so it can act as a powerful oxidizing agent. It acts as an oxidizing agent. So ozone, O3, on decomposition it liberates O2 and O, nascent oxygen. Because of that liberation of nascent oxygen, it acts as a powerful reducing agent, and it oxidizes lead sulfide to PbS, lead sulfide to lead sulfate, PbSO4, and it oxidizes I minus to I2. Here oxidation state of lead is minus. Here it PbS is oxidized to PbSO4, and here it oxidizes I minus to I2. Let us see the reaction. It oxidizes lead sulfide to lead sulfate and I minus to I2. These are the two reactions where ozone acts as an oxidizing agent. So this one is an important equation, oxidation of lead sulfide to lead sulfate, PbS plus O3 to give PbSO4 plus 4O2. Important reaction, and it oxidizes I minus to iodine, I2. Okay. So while writing this reaction, PbS to PbSO4, we can write it like this. So ozone on decomposition, it decomposes to give O2 and nascent oxygen, and PbS by using that nascent oxygen oxidizes PbSO4. So here there are 4 oxygen atoms, so we should write here 4 nascent oxygen. So in order to get 4 nascent oxygen, this equation has to be multiplied by 4. So that we can write the equation like this, PbS plus 4 nascent oxygen and 4 nascent oxygen gets cancelled, O3, that is 4O3, and to give PbSO4 plus 4O2. So this is the balanced equation for the oxidation of lead sulfide to lead sulfate. Okay. Therefore, we have written here 4O3 and 4O2. Okay. So on decomposition, ozone releases nascent oxygen along with O2, and lead sulfide oxidizes by nascent oxygen to lead sulfate. And then to balance here for O4, we should multiply it by 4 nascent oxygen. So in order to get 4 nascent oxygen, you have to multiply this equation by 4, and by writing net equation we get PbS plus 4O3 to give PbSO4 plus 4O2. Next, ozone reacts with excess of potassium iodide. When ozone reacts with excess of potassium iodide, O3, when it reacts with potassium iodide, it liberates excess of iodine. It liberates iodine. That liberated iodine is titrated against hypo solution or sodium thiosulfate solution, Na2S2O3 and 5H2O, sodium thiosulfate solution, right? So when ozone is treated with excess of potassium iodide, it releases iodine, and this reaction is carried out in the presence of buffer solution of pH 9.2. the buffer solution is borate buffer. Means it is a mixture of sodium tetraborate or borax and boric acid, that is Na2B4O7 10H2O borax or sodium tetraborate and boric acid H3BO3. The mixture of these two is called borate buffer, which gives a pH of 9.2. So buffer is a solution which has the capacity to resist the change in pH by adding a little amount of an acid or a base. So when ozone reacts with the excess of potassium iodide in the presence of borate buffer, it liberates iodine. The liberated iodine, this is taken place in a conical flask. When iodine is liberated, it is titrated against sodium thiosulfate solution, right? So by knowing the amount of sodium thiosulfate consumed during titration, we can get the amount of iodine liberated, and from that iodine liberated, we can get the amount of ozone present in the given sample. So this is the quantitative method for the estimation of ozone gas. ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಓಝೋನ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ನಮಗೆ ಇದರಿಂದ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಓಝೋನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್. ವೆನ್ ಓಝೋನ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ಇರುವ ಓಝೋನ್ ಇರುವಂಥ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೀಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಷಿಯಂ ಅಯೋಡೈಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್. Ozone reacts with excess of potassium iodide solution, which is buffered with the borate buffer of pH 9.2. iodine is liberated, and that liberated iodine is titrated against the standard solution of sodium thiosulfate. So from the amount of sodium thiosulfate consumed, we can get the amount of iodine liberated. By that in turn, we can get the amount of ozone present in the given sample. Next is nitrogen oxides, particularly nitric oxide NO, rapidly combines with ozone. So nitrogen oxides emitted from the supersonic jet aeroplanes might be slowly depleting the concentration of the ozone layer. You might have observed the process of depletion of ozone layer, which is a very harmful process that is caused by the freons or CFC, chlorofluorocarbons, and also it is caused by the nitric oxide, by the presence of nitric oxide. And this nitric oxide is liberated from the exhaust system of the supersonic jet aeroplanes. Adrinda emit ada nitric oxide enide that depletes the ozone layer, and it combines with ozone to form nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. Right, so this is one of the main cause for the depletion of the ozone layer. And also, you know, chlorofluorocarbons that is released from the refrigerator also one of the cause for the depletion of the ozone layer. And the freons, which are used in aerosol sprays and refrigerants, also depletes the ozone layer. Next, uses of ozone. It is used as a germicide, disinfectant, and for sterilizing water, used for bleaching oils, ivory and floor and starch, etc. Used as an oxidizing agent in the manufacture of potassium permanganate. So these are the important uses of ozone, right? Next, let us move on to the next element present in a group 16, that is sulfur. I hope you remember the elements present in group 16: oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium and livermorium. The second important element of the group 16 is sulfur. So sulfur exists in many allotropic form. In that, the most important allotropic forms are alpha sulfur and beta sulfur. Alpha sulfur and beta sulfur. Alpha sulfur is also called rhombic sulfur, and beta sulfur is also called monoclinic sulfur. So rhombic and monoclinic sulfur, it is the two types of crystalline forms of sulfur. Rhombic sulfur, alpha sulfur or rhombic sulfur, beta sulfur or monoclinic sulfur. So rhombic sulfur, the you might have studied in topic solids that the rhombic is one of the type of unit cell with the cell dimensions of A not equal to B not equal to C, and alpha, beta, gammas are equal to 90 degree. These are the edge lengths of a cube, A, B and C, not a cube but a unit cell, edge length of unit cell, A not equal to B and not equal to C, and alpha, beta, gammas are equal to 90 degree for rhombic. And for monoclinic, A not equal to B not equal to C, all edge lengths are not equal to each other, and alpha and gammas are equal to 90 degree, whereas beta is not equal to 90 degree. These are the parameters of monoclinic and rhombic unit cells, right? So sulfur exists in two forms, yellow rhombic or alpha sulfur, beta sulfur or monoclinic sulfur. In the room temperature, only the rhombic sulfur is more stable. Room temperature alli rhombic sulfur more stable agirthade. And 369 Kelvin is called transition temperature, because below 369 Kelvin alpha sulfur is the more stable form of sulfur, and above 369 Kelvin beta sulfur is the most stable allotropic form of sulfur. At 369 Kelvin both the forms are stable, hence this temperature is called transition temperature. Right, below 369 Kelvin alpha sulfur is a more stable form, and above 369 Kelvin beta sulfur is a most stable form of sulfur. At 369 Kelvin both the forms are stable, hence it is called transition temperature. And alpha sulfur is prepared by evaporating the solution of Rawl sulfur in carbon disulfide. Rawl sulfur means sulfur present in a roll, or roll sulfur. It is evaporating the Rawl sulfur in carbon disulfide. It is readily soluble in carbon disulfide, but it is insoluble in water, and it is soluble to some extent in alcohol, benzene and ether, right? So these are some properties of alpha sulfur. It is stable at room temperature, and above 369 Kelvin it is transformed into beta sulfur, and it is prepared by evaporating the solution of Rawl sulfur in carbon disulfide, and it is soluble in carbon disulfide but it is insoluble in water. The two most important allotropic forms of sulfur are yellow rhombic alpha sulfur and monoclinic sulfur, and the properties are like this. This is yellow in color. Melting point is 385.8 Kelvin and specific gravity 2.06. It is formed on evaporating the solution of Rawl sulfur in carbon disulfide. It is insoluble in water but dissolved to some extent in benzene, alcohol and ether. It is readily soluble in carbon disulfide. Next is monoclinic sulfur or beta sulfur. Melting point is 393 Kelvin and specific gravity of 1.98. It is soluble in carbon disulfide. It is soluble in carbon disulfide. So monoclinic sulfur or beta sulfur is prepared by dissolving alpha sulfur in a dish, right? By dissolving alpha sulfur in a suitable solvent, and it is cooled till crust is formed. Andre adra surface mele ondu hard layer create aguvarege navu adannu cool maadbeku. Once a crust is formed, make a two hole on that crust and remove the excess of liquid present in that, and after removing the crust, we can observe a white needle shaped crystals of beta sulfur. Okay, so we can prepare the monoclinic sulfur by dissolving alpha sulfur in a solvent, and it is allowed to cool till the crust is formed. Once the crust is formed, you have to make holes on that crust and remove the excess of solvent present in it. Then and after that, remove that crust, and after removing the crust, we can observe white needle shaped crystals of monoclinic sulfur. So it is prepared by melting rhombic sulfur in a dish and cooling till crust is formed. Two holes are made in the crust and the remaining liquid poured out. On removing crust, colorless needle shaped crystals of beta sulfur are formed. It is stable above 369 Kelvin and transforms into alpha sulfur below it. As I said earlier, 369 Kelvin is a transition temperature, and both alpha sulfur and beta sulfurs have Puckett shape. Puckett means they are not planar structure. They have S8 molecules. S8 molecules means sulfur has S8 molecules, and these have crown shape. Crown shape means so this is a structure of S8 molecules which has crown shape. So many other modifications of sulfur has been found, that is, which contains 6 to 20 atoms of sulfur per ring, right? And at elevated temperature, S2 is a dominant species. S2 that is nearly 1000 Kelvin. At nearly 1000 Kelvin, S2 is a dominant species, and it is paramagnetic, like that of oxygen, O2. And here, this is a structure of alpha sulfur and beta sulfur, crown shape. And one more form of sulfur is S6, which is also non-planar and which has chair form. So this is a chair form of S6 molecule. There are 6 sulfur atoms per molecule, and this is the crown shape of S8 molecules. Right? So these are the structures of sulfur, S8 and S6 molecules. Next important compound of sulfur is sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is a colorless gas with a pungent odor, and it is highly soluble in water. It can be liquefied in room temperature by applying 2 atmospheric pressure. Let us see the preparation of sulfur dioxide. So sulfur dioxide can be prepared by burning of sulfur with oxygen. Sulfur dioxide is produced along with the 6 to 8% of sulfur trioxide. So sulfur plus O2 to give sulfur dioxide. One of the method of preparation of sulfur dioxide by burning sulfur with oxygen, and it also gives a traces of sulfur trioxide. And in the laboratory, it is prepared by treating sulfite with the dilute sulfuric acid. Sulfite salt means sulfate andre SO4, sulfite andre SO3. Sodium sulfite formula is Na2SO3, sodium sulfite adra ionic formula na bariwaga SO3 2 minus anta barutteve. Sulfite, it is treated with the sulfuric acid. It gives sulfur dioxide along with water. And in the industrial industry, sulfur dioxide is produced as a byproduct during roasting of sulfide ores. Industrially, it is obtained as a byproduct of the roasting of sulfide ores. FeS2, iron sulfide, when it is heated with the excess of oxygen, it gives Fe2O3 and along with the sulfur dioxide. So this is a byproduct during the conversion of sulfide ore into oxygen, oxide ore of iron, right? So these are the three methods of preparation of sulfur dioxide: by burning sulfur with oxygen, and in the laboratory it is prepared by treating a sulfite salt with the sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid, and industrially it is obtained as a byproduct of the roasting of sulfide ores. Next, let us see the properties of sulfur dioxide. It is a colorless gas with a pungent odor, and it is highly soluble in water. It liquefies at room temperature under a pressure of 2 atmosphere and boils at 263 Kelvin. Sulfur dioxide reacts with water forming sulfurous acid. So SO2, when reacts with water, it gives S2SO3, sulfurous acid, right? So sulfurous acid may decomposes to give H+ ion, hence sulfur dioxide is considered as a acidic oxide. And sulfur dioxide reacts with sodium hydroxide forming sodium sulfide, which again reacts with the excess of sulfur dioxide forming sodium hydrogen sulfide. So when sulfur dioxide reacts with the sodium hydroxide, it gives sodium sulfide Na2SO3 plus water, and this Na2SO3 again reacts with the excess of sulfur dioxide and it gives sodium hydrogen sulfide NaHSO3. Sodium hydrogen sulfide. So this is a reaction of sulfur dioxide with the sodium hydroxide. So sodium hydroxide reacts with sulfur dioxide to form sodium sulfide and water, and excess of sodium sulfide sodium sulfide reacts with excess of sulfur dioxide to form sodium hydrogen sulfide. So its reaction with the water or sodium hydroxide is very much similar to that of carbon dioxide. The reaction of sulfur dioxide with water and sodium hydroxide is similar to that of carbon dioxide. Andre iga navu illi sulfur dioxide badru carbon dioxide baradre carbon dioxide plus water to give H2CO3, that is carbonic acid, and carbon dioxide plus sodium hydroxide gives sodium carbonate Na2CO3, then sodium carbonate gives sodium bicarbonate NaHCO3, right? So reaction of sodium sulfur dioxide with the water and sodium hydroxide is similar to that of carbon dioxide. Next, sulfur dioxide reacts with chlorine. Sulfur dioxide reacts with chlorine in the presence of charcoal catalyst forming sulfuryl chloride SO2Cl2. Sulfur dioxide, when it reacts with chlorine in the presence of charcoal catalyst, it gives sulfuryl chloride. And sulfur dioxide gets oxidized to sulfur trioxide by oxygen in the presence of vanadium pentoxide as a catalyst. So sulfur dioxide is converted into sulfur trioxide by reaction with oxygen in the presence of vanadium pentoxide as a catalyst. So these are the two catalytic reactions of sulfur dioxide. Next important one is moist sulfur dioxide behaves as a reducing agent. Moist sulfur dioxide behaves as a reducing agent. It reduces Fe3 to Fe2+ ions. It converts Fe3+ ions to Fe2+ ions. It is a reducing agent, but it undergoes oxidation to SO sulfate ion, right? Iga idralli oxidation state +3 itu, Fe2 alli +2, so this it undergo reduction. It is a reducing agent. It reduces, but itself it undergoes oxidation. Here the oxidation sulfur A of sulfur is plus 4 and here it is plus 6. It is plus 6. So it undergoes oxidation. Sulfur undergoes oxidation from plus 4 to plus 6, whereas Fe3 plus undergo reduction to Fe2 plus ion. And you have to balance this equation according to the redox reaction, whatever you have studied in first year. ನೀವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಡಾಕ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಲ್ವ, ಅದು ಆ ಮೆಥಡಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನು ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಐಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಒನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ Fe3 ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟು Fe2 ಪ್ಲಸ್, ದ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1, ರೈಟ್, ಪ್ಲಸ್ 3 ಟು ಪ್ಲಸ್ 2. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಟು ಸಲ್ಫೇಟ್ SO4 2 minus, here it is plus 4 and here it is plus 6, so change in oxidation state is plus 2, right? And multiply the redox reaction to the extent of oxidation and multiply the oxidation equation by the extent of reduction and write the net reaction. So here Fe3 plus is multiplied by 2, so that becomes 2Fe3 plus plus SO2, and that is multiplied by 1, that becomes SO2. And here the Fe2 plus is multiplied by 2, that is 2Fe2 plus, and this is SO4 2 minus, right? So next charge balance, you have to balance the charge. So this is plus 6 and this is plus 4 and minus 2. Plus 4 and minus 2, that becomes plus 2, right? And the reaction takes place in acidic medium, so in order to balance this one, here it is plus 6 and this is plus 4, you have to add plus 4 or 4H, 4H plus. So this is 4H plus, so to balance that you have to write H2O. Sorry, that should be 2H2O, this is 2H2O. So this is how we are writing the balanced equation. 2Fe3 plus plus SO2 plus 2H2O to give 2Fe2 plus plus SO4 2 minus plus 4H plus, right? So this is one of the example for the reducing nature of sulfur dioxide, moist sulfur dioxide. It acts as a reducing agent. And second example is it decolorizes potassium permanganate. Right? Potassium permanganate is a dark violet colored liquid, and when sulfur dioxide gas is passed through that liquid, it decolorizes. That indicates the presence of sulfur dioxide gas, right? That also useful to detect the presence of the gas. So moist sulfur dioxide decolorizes acidified potassium permanganate solution. This is used as a test for gas. So this is potassium permanganate written in the ionic form MnO4 minus, and moist sulfur dioxide. So sulfur dioxide plus water, and sulfur dioxide is oxidized to sulfate ion, and MnO4 minus is reduced to Mn2 plus. So this is a reaction used to detect the presence of sulfur dioxide. ಇದರ ಕಲರ್ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ವಾಲೆಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಬಟ್ ನಾವು ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಆ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಕಲರ್ಲೆಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಟು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. Used in the refining of petroleum and sugar, in bleaching wool and silk, used as disinfectant and preservative. Liquid sulfur dioxide is used as a solvent to dissolve a number of organic and inorganic chemicals. These are the important uses of sulfur dioxide. So next is oxo acids of sulfur. Oxo acids of sulfur. So here oxides means when an element combines with oxygen, the resulting compound is called oxide. Hydride means when it combines with hydrogen. But when so element combines with both hydrogen and oxygen, that compounds are called oxo acids. Oxo means oxygen, acids means it contains H plus ion and that element, next element. So there are three elements, oxygen, hydrogen along with the element. So there are four important oxo acids of sulfur. First is sulfurous acid. Sulfurous acid, H2SO3, sulfuric acid, H2SO4, then peroxo disulfuric acid, that is H2S2O8, pyrosulfuric acid, H2S2O7, it is also called oleum. So these are the important four oxo acids of sulfur: sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid, peroxo disulfuric acid and pyrosulfuric acid. So let us write the structure of this. Sulfurous acid . So H2SO3 along with the presence of lone pair of electrons. So this is structure of H2SO3, sulfurous acid. For sulfuric acid, one more oxygen is added to it by replacing the lone pair of electrons. So we can write the structure like this, H2SO3. Sorry, H2SO4. Next, peroxo disulfuric acid. Peroxo disulfuric acid is S double bond O, double bond O and OH, and here also S double bond O, double bond O and OH. Peroxo means there are two oxygen atoms. There is a OO bond, that bond is called peroxo bond. So this is H2S2O8. Right? Next, remove one oxygen from here, that gives pyrosulfuric acid. Actually, pyro means heating, that is H2SO4 plus H2SO4. When it is two molecules of a compound is combined, and when a molecule of water is removed from that, we get pyro of that compound, that is pyrosulfuric acid. By adding two molecules of sulfuric acid and remove a molecule of water from that, H2 4 minus 2, again 2, H2 and 4 plus 4 7 7 minus 1 sorry 8 4 plus 4 8 8 minus 1 gives 7. So that is pyrosulfuric acid. The right structure is similar to and it is also called oleum, H2S2O7. So these are the structures of four oxo acids of sulfuric acid. In that, the important oxo acid of sulfur is sulfuric acid. Important oxo acid of sulfur is sulfuric acid. Just write the structure of these. Next, let us study about the properties of sulfuric acid. So, sulfuric acid is a colorless oily liquid. and the chemical, it is also called king of chemicals. Sulfuric acid is called king of chemicals. The chemical reactions of sulfuric acid is because of its four properties, that is because of its low volatility, strong acidic character, strong affinity for water, and ability to act as an oxidizing agent. Because of these four property of sulfuric acid, it is considered as a very important compound in chemical industry. Let us study one by one. Strong acidic character of sulfuric acid. So when sulfuric acid H2SO4 combines with water, it forms H3O+ and HSO4-. The dissociation constant for this reaction is 10. Ka1 is 10, and HSO4 ion again combines with water and it forms H3O+ and sulfate ion SO4-. The dissociation constant for this reaction is 1.2 into 10 to the power minus 10. Right? So the high value of Ka1 indicates that sulfuric acid, when it reacts with water, it mainly present in the form of H3O+, hydronium ion, and HSO4-. This hydrogenium ion again dissociates to give H+ and H2O. Due to the large Ka value, it indicates that it is a strong acid. Sulfuric acid is a strong acid. Whereas in the second step, the Ka value or dissociation constant value is less. But in the first step, it is very high. That indicates that higher the value of Ka, stronger is the acid. And when the sulfuric acid is dissolved in water, it releases large amount of heat. So care must be taken while preparing sulfuric acid solution from the concentrated sulfuric acid solution. We have to add acid to water, not water to acid. Now in the concentrated stock solution in the dilute sulfuric acid prepare maduvaga yavaglu water ge acid hakbeku, acid ge water hakbardu, because sulfuric acid liberates large amount of heat when it is dissolved in water, right? This is evidence for the first property of sulfuric acid, a strong acidic character, because it has high Ka value of 10. So high Ka value indicates that it mainly present as H3O+ and HSO4-, and it liberates H+ ion, right? And next let us consider the low volatility. So because of the low volatility of sulfuric acid, it is used to prepare more volatile acids. For example, MX of metal halide, where halide means chloride, fluoride or nitrate. Here X and telidre may be chloride, fluoride or nitrate, NO3. When it reacts with sulfuric acid, it gives HX, either hydrogen fluoride, hydrogen chloride or HNO3, plus M2SO4. So because of the less volatility of sulfuric acid, it is used to prepare more volatile acids. General reaction is MX, where M is a metal and X may be chlorine, fluorine and nitrate, and H2SO4, HX plus M2SO4. So there is one in-text question on this. Write the equation when calcium fluoride reacts with the sulfuric acid. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಒಂದು ಇಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ಕಲ್ಲಿ, ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ರೆಫರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಎಸಿಡಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಲ್ಫ್ಯೂರಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೋ ವೊಲಟ್ಯಾಲಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಟೂ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ್ಯಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಎಫಿನಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಟು ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಏಜೆಂಟ್. ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.